Can't be drowned by the sound of guns. Won't just watch a tragic time through a satellite dish. The least that we can give you is an anthem light.
This photo is for the dirty bastard Emmanuel Macron, the pig of the French Republic, the biggest hypocrite in history. France, they call it the capital of enlightenment, and I call it the capital of prostitution. And everybody won't search that, can search how many prostitutes in France, in Bigale and Saint-Lazare and Montparnasse, and this is there. The dirty bastard is a Freemason, big enemy of Islam. And we as a Muslim have to step, because if any Muslim doesn't defend his prophet, he shouldn't be called a Muslim. He should be a pimp or a cuck or a pig. This is your prophet. This is the one Allah sent to save all humanity. And we Muslim now in a weak position, but everybody's scared for Muslimin. Everybody's scared. Even when we are down, when we are weak, everybody's scared. Why? Because as I just said to the brother, the whole Western civilization built on the wreckage of the Islamic State, the Ottoman State, 600 years ruling from China to Switzerland. They told us the Ottoman was the state of the sick man. Yes, Sultan Abdul Hamid, may Allah bless him, he was sick, he was ill, but he didn't sell Palestine. He didn't sell Al-Quds. When they asked him, give it to us, he said, no. If you want to take it by force, I cannot give it to you. Imagine a weak and sick a state, 600 years running the show, and the man wouldn't give in. This is the Ottoman. This is the Ottoman who finished the Byzantine dynasty, one of the biggest in biggest state in history. He finished them off. This is the state which the Saudi bastard Al Saud went against them. And they make khuruj, they make rebellion against. Now, are you better off? Are you better off? They chop you now, they chop your balls. Before Europe used to search and wait who's gonna be the next caliph or the next ruler. Why? To study him quickly and to know how they're gonna defeat him. Now you bums, you study who's gonna be president here or prime minister here and bring the jizya to go and give him your bloody dirty oil money. Even your dirty money, use it for killing people. You kill people in Yemen. You dirty coward. You make embargo against Gaza people. The dirty Emirate people, they bloody buy the houses from the Palestinians. And they said, oh, we're gonna make it hotels and this and that, and you give it to the dynasty. You are, insha'Allah, by the willing of Allah, you're gonna be remembered in the dustbin of history that you are coward, you have no honor, you have no will, you have no power. Why? Why you bastard, you buy a weapon to fight the whole world, and you're asking the British to defend your oil fields? Why you cannot finish the Al-Houthi? That 5% of Yemen, Yemen is 30 million, 5% is what? 5% is 15 of the 100. What is the 5% of 30? 1.5 million? Why? Why don't finish them off? Why you The coalition, why you have a coalition to fight the Yemeni, the Houthi? You scared from the cockroach because you dirty coward bastard. Yes,
because America told them.
You, America told you, they scare you from Iran, you buying weapon. They scare you from Yemen, you buying weapon. They scare you from Turkey, you buying. You piece of dirt, MBS and Al Saud. Why you making embargo? Why you making sanction against Turkey? Why you helping the Armenian? And you are against the Azari. Aren't the Azari Muslim? You help Christian? You side with Macron? This dirty bastard going and Armenia occupied an island, land island in middle of Azerbaijan.
I'm not a doctor, but I talk from Islamic point of view. The Prophet ﷺ said, إذا رأيتم الطاعون في أرض فلا تذهبوا لها ولا تخرجوا منها. If you see a plague or an infectious disease, don't leave the town you are in and don't go to the town if it's infected. So I leave that to the medical, and I don't trust politicians. And I don't know if this real lockdown and tier 4 and this, is it reality or fake? Because I believe these financial gains and financial, the financial side control most of the decision in this country. A human worth nothing, a human is like little piece of goods. You don't care about it. And God knows, but I ask everybody to be careful. As our Prophet said, this hygiene, increase the hygiene. And don't say, some Muslims say, I rely on Allah. This is wrong. You have to do your business, you do your job, and you rely on Allah. Like if they tell you wear mask, and you rely on Allah. If they tell you wash your hand with disinfectant or antibacterial, do it. And don't go to discotheque over Christmas. Don't hug, don't drink too much. And if you are locked down, it's a very good chance to know about Islam. Because Islam is one tablet, can give you cure for all the diseases. You take the tablet of Islam, you don't gamble, you don't be sodomite, you don't be lesbian, you don't smoke, you don't take drugs, you don't do abortion, you don't take alcohol, you don't do usury, you don't do all the dirty things. You be kind to the dog, to animals, you be kind to birds, and you be kind to your neighbor. In Islam, if your neighbor sleep hungry, you are out of Islam. You should check on your neighbor. Thank you very much, and short and nice.
Thank you.